Welcome back, my Planet Coaster friends. Johnny5 Alive here, and we are back with another episode of Yeti Land Let's Play. And we got a lot of fun stuff in store for you guys, so stay tuned and let's check it out. All right, let's dive right into it. So, last episode we left off, we were doing our lighting and stuff. If you haven't seen any of those episodes, go check them out and get caught up a little bit. Everything here is at 6x speed, so it goes really quick. You'll get to see me build a lot of stuff. So right now we're going to be finishing up our lighting, but this episode is actually going to be a really fun one. And I was looking at the end of the footage because I did 28 recordings or something over the weekend. And I got a lot done, and the recordings are all different lengths. So I put all the recordings into Premiere and then I speed them all up to 6x speed, and then I kind of scan through the footage and see what we're doing. So by looking at the footage, I saw a lot of animations and posing of the Yetis. So it looks like in this episode, we're actually going to be getting to destroying that gingerbread train station that we have over there, because we have two gingerbread stations. One is going to be brand new, crisp and clean, and the second one is going to be kind of in the Yeti territory, and it's sort of being overrun and taken over by the Yetis, and they're sort of salvaging it for as sort of like food, because they like to eat gingerbread. So right now we are doing our lightings. We're finishing up the lighting for the lake, the pond, all the little rivers and stuff, and then once we're done that, we move over to the gingerbread house. And out of all the recordings and where we're at right now, like after all these episodes get released or chopped down and I talk over them and we release them and turn them into episodes, where we are in the current state of Yeti Land as of right now, in the time of making this recording, it is Tuesday, and I'll probably get to work on this a little bit more on the weekend, and I think right now we're in a really good spot. So in the next coming episodes, you're going to see a lot of fun creations. We'll be doing a little bit of animating with the Yetis. We're going to be telling a story, you know, with our characters. We're getting everything to the final stages so we can prepare for the Yeti War. And we had all these plans in store. Like, if you've watched any of the other episodes, we talked about, you know, building the Mama Yeti, which we did that, and then we wanted to hang lights off her arms and have the baby Yetis crawling all over her and hanging the ropes. We did that. We wanted to get the sculpting and the lighting to a certain stage. You're seeing that all come together now. In terms of the map, we're not going to be adding too much more or changing too much more with the terrain. However, I did get an idea, and I wanted to do a little bit of something for underground. A nice little surprise coming for that in the future here. So we're going to be working a little bit of the terrain again sometime in the future, but not too much. For the most part, our layout is done, and it's all about getting our story told and getting everything up to a point where the scenario is complete. So right now, for those of you who don't know, we're building a scenario map that kind of is like a career mode map in some senses, where you can take it into challenge mode. And the map is going to have everything you see here with the Papa Yeti, the Mama Yeti, the Yeti War. But for the most part, there's going to be a lot of blank spots for you to build on. And it's going to be fully lit. It's going to come with 5 custom train stations that I built. And we're probably gonna do a coaster or two, maybe even a ride. So it's gonna come with a couple attractions that are custom designed to the map, and they're not gonna take up too much space. So you're still gonna have a ton of work or ton of area to build on. And you know, so you could build a park on. Once the scenario is completed, I'm going to save that map off separately. We'll have that as a blueprint for everybody to download and start building and playing their own Yeti Land map, and building a park on this. Then from there, I'm going to actually technically start the let's build, or the let's play, I should say. So once we get it to a certain point, where the scenario is complete, I'll actually start building a park on it. We'll open it up to the guests. We'll put rides down, shops, attractions, probably grab some workshop blueprints, put them in there. Lots of festive ones. We'll have like a little gingerbread town. We're going to build a sci-fi town using my sci-fi universe that I've been working on. If you haven't checked out my workshop, go check that out. I have over 35 cohesive blueprints for sci-fi, large, medium, small, and humongous versions of all sorts of different shops that are all cohesive for a sci-fi universe. And we're going to take advantage of using some of those for these one area here on the map. There's that futuristic sci-fi station that I built over there, which is kind of like letting everyone into the sci-fi land. And the sci-fi land also tells its own story, because we're going to use some sort of gates or fences to sort of separate Yeti Land from the actual park. So the one side of Yeti Land is all destroyed and in war, and it's all taken over by the Yetis, and then the other side of the park is a lot more friendly and protected, and there's going to be a combination between festive gingerbread town and sci-fi. So that's the plan for the Let's Play, but none of that stuff is going to be included in the scenario. It's just some train stations, it's just a few rides, and that's it, and a whole bunch of blank spots. So you could pretty much do whatever you want with it, change it however you want, or run with the current theme, and it'll be a lot of fun. So both the scenario and the final map will be uploaded to the Steam Workshop. And that'll be awesome. So here, you know, I'm trying to talk and give a little story and fill everybody in, because the task you see here is kind of tedious. It is sped up, but it is part of the process. And I want to hide all these exposed lights, but I want to give everything this nice mystical bluey glow feel that I talked a lot more about in the previous episodes. So while it is boring, I want to include everything in the process so you guys can understand what I'm doing and why I'm doing it, and you can get your own ideas. So it is what it is. I try to make things interesting while we wait, but this episode does have a lot of fun stuff coming up. So this gives me a nice time to catch everybody up to speed, talk about things, and talk about the future plans of the park while we just kind of place some things in. And you can see that one area where it's kind of shallow. It's very, very glowy. And I do end up fixing that a little bit by making the water a bit deeper, because I didn't really like how bright it was in comparison to everything else. I talk about being cohesive and having things look the same throughout the map, and I don't want certain areas of the map to be overly bright compared to other areas of the map. So I'm just trying to figure things out as I go. But I do want all the underbellies and the crevices, certain things to be really mystical and icy feeling. So this is the part where I was saying I fixed it. It was a little bit too bright because it's so shallow and the snow is so close to the surface of the water, it glows that much brighter. So I had to go in there with the push tool and kind of lower everything a little bit to add a little bit more dark water in and kind of get rid of that snow, which is kind of unfortunate. I probably should have done that first, but I didn't know how it was gonna look until I placed the lights. And then, you know, pulling back the camera, I noticed that maybe it's a little bit too bright. So I had to fix that and then readjust all the lights around the outside. But it went pretty quickly. It wasn't too big of a deal, and we got it done, and we're just about finished here. So it's a little bit less bright than it used to be. It still is very bright. I wasn't sure about this edge here, so I was trying to pull it out and play with it, but it looked a little bit too spotty and splotchy, so I ended up leaving it. But it's okay that some areas are a little bit brighter than others. I mean, you know, the areas that have more water, that are deeper, that have a bigger drop-off into the water, it makes sense that they're not as glowy and they're a little bit darker. So I'm pretty happy with the end result, and we end up doing, I talked about doing a last minute adjustment to the terrain that we're going to do later, and we're going to do some underground cave, and it's going to be near that really glowy spot, so hopefully we'll be able to add a little bit of contrast and almost like a focal point around that area. So it'll make more sense to why it's so glowy over there, and we'll turn it into something interesting later. later. And here I'm just adding more glowiness to the rocks because I like the way this looks, and I'm trying to hide the spotlights but just have a little bit of an illumination to the rock surface and get it looking pretty cool. So we want everything to have this icy feel on our terrain and this mystical feel. So I want to try and illuminate a lot of the rock surfaces where I can. And here I was having troubles getting that part to work, so I just left it. And there's a few caves that I noticed that I forgot to light up. And we do a combination of like almost like a lighter teal blue and then a darker blue to give us a little bit of a gradient and some mismatch between the colors. And so it adds a little bit more interest to the eye rather than just the same blue everywhere. So I'm just lighting up little crevices in different areas and smoothing out this rock. Some final, you know, tuning adjustments. And and I felt like maybe we needed a little bit more light back here to kind of lead you into the cave, bring some interest to the eye there as well. And I'm just looking over everything and seeing if I like it. So this is where we start our preparations for the fun stuff. In one of the last episodes, I created a path and a bridge and all that, and I was talking about how the Yetis are going to be looting this town and looting the gingerbread and stealing candy and all that stuff. Well, they need a pathway to go back home because they're taking all this stuff, and we want this story to be told realistically. So they essentially need a route of navigation. So we're constructing this sort of pathway slash hill so that they can go to and from. And, you know, the Mama Yeti is letting them down with her little Christmas light ropes out the front. And that's how they get out in mass numbers. She descends them down. But we need them to be able to lug loot up and down. And the Mama Yeti's not going to exactly be able to do that, so they have to be self-sufficient at times, and they can't always rely on Mama. So we're building a pathway for them so that they can do that, and I just wanted to carve out some interesting paths and make it look kind of constructed a little bit. And then I was thinking about making a path here for the guests to get up there, because we're going to be doing something in there and we want the guests to be able to get up there. But I didn't like that idea, and I'm gonna figure something out later. I think I might have some canals going up there, and the guests will have to go through underground pathways, and they'll get up there in a sort of hidden route. So here I'm just kind of adding wear to the pathway, as if they've been walking back and forth so much that the snow is sort of gone because they're walking. And then I wanted a nice transition between the dirt and the rock on the inside. And so that's their long pathway from the gingerbread station all the way to the Yeti cave. So now we're actually going to get into the fun stuff. So I didn't really know how I was going to approach this, and I think I did a couple things off camera that I was just that you won't see, but you'll see in the end result. Here and there I'll be like, oh, I should have deleted this, or I should have moved that around. And in between recordings I do minor tweaks while I'm thinking about things. I just, in between recordings, I stop, I think about things, and I go, okay, what do I want to do next, so that all of that thinking and stuff is not on camera. But for the most part, you get to see all of it. So this here, somebody suggested in the comments of the last episode, you should do a train that has been stepped on by Papa Yeti in the footprints. So I did remember seeing a blueprint a long time ago in the Steam Workshop of a crashed train. So you saw me put that blueprint down, and I deleted all the rocks because it was for a western map or desert map, and I deleted everything that didn't work with it for our theme. I've connected it to a building piece so we can move it all around as one, and I'm trying to figure out a good spot to put this crashed train. So I thought right in front of the foot pad would be awesome, so when he stepped, the train crashed into him and into his foot, and that's where it like piled up. So we're gonna need train tracks, so it's almost like train tracks split, and they have like train crossings or whatever. And we wanted to make it believable in the sense that this train was supposed to go somewhere else. So one train goes to the train station and one takes you to the next destination, like another park or another map. So I decided I would tell a story with these train tracks and sort of lead them to another destination. So they were supposed to go past his feet here, or where his feet are now, into a cave. So I make a cave here, and I don't have to really take this anywhere other than into a pitch black zone. So this, we're just trying to like carve this out, get a few tracks, and get it running in there, and we'll have a, like, the light will be shining enough to see that this track goes somewhere, and then it just sort of goes into a blackness, and then the light dims away. Just to tell a story that this train actually goes to another area or another place, but if you were to look in there closely and light it up, you would notice that it really doesn't go anywhere. We're just making the illusion that it goes somewhere. So we're adding all these little busted up train pieces to look like he actually stepped on it and the train busted and cracked, and just trying to give it a little bit of character and also destruction. So we want to illuminate this cave a bit, but not too much, just so you can see the train track going in somewhere. See, I'm pulling it back and I'm trying to find the right spot, and we found the right spot. So the it goes into a cave and it goes off into, you know, Never Never Land, who knows. So now I decided it's time to like break this train station. So they've been taking pieces of the gingerbread back with them, and you know, we have to just take away some of those pieces. So it's like, okay, the pieces aren't there anymore because they brought it home or they ate it. So we're just randomly selecting pieces and destroying the heck out of it, and just going, okay, well, let's destroy it a bit. But we also want to have our Yetis playing on it. We want them looting it. So we're going to have, we have all these posed animations that we did in like episode 4 or 5. We posed all these Yetis. So we're taking them and we're bringing them over there so that we can use them in poses. Now they are in a separate building, and I changed this later on at some point in this episode because I had to take them out, then separate them, and then select them and add them into that building. And it was getting a little bit tedious doing that every time I wanted to add a Yeti, so I ended up deselecting all of those guys from a group and adding all of them into the gingerbread house, so that every time I grabbed one and moved him in or duplicated him, he was already a part of the new building. But luckily, because this is 6x speed, you don't really see that tedious process. It goes so quickly. You really just see me moving them. You don't really see me adding them to the selection too much. You saw it there for a second, but it goes really quickly. So I just like have that guy like pulling out a piece of the gingerbread roof. I had an idea here where if I take this piece off, it's almost like somebody's taking that piece off and looting it. And then I had an idea of maybe putting someone inside of that that house there, like poking out. So I'm trying to figure out which guy to use for that. And I put this guy in there, so he's kind of busting out of the rooftop. And I'm just having fun at this point. This is a really cool episode. It's a lot of like little tedious tasks to do here because you got to pose them, put them in, and you know, but a lot of it's just like stemming from pure imagination. Like, what can I do? What can I do? Let's see here. And you know, coming up with fun ideas. So he's holding the cookie there. I, you know, he busted out of the top and he's like, cookie. So these Yetis are destructive little boys, and they're just having fun. And even the girls are destructive as well. It's in their nature, so we'll be adding some of the girls in as well. And someone did mention in one of the previous comments for one of the other episodes, it would be nice if you sort of made it hard to tell which ones were the girls and which one were the boys. A lot of the girls have the red eyelids, or pink eyelids, and rosy cheeks and bows. And we will do a little bit of mixing it up. We'll give some of the girls hats, we'll give some of the boys bows, and we'll switch it up so it makes it harder to tell which ones are boys and which ones are girls. They're all just crazy. So I wanted that guy kind of busting out of the window. I thought that looked kind of cool. I had got that idea from our 1,000 subscriber sign that I built. And just trying to reuse some of the ideas that I did previously. Here you'll see me, I'm fiddling with it because I want to get all these guys added into the gingerbread house. That's what I was talking about earlier, where I want them to be a part of the gingerbread so that every time I use another one, I don't have to fiddle with it anymore. It's already a part of the building. So this guy's stealing the Channel 5 gaming sign. I thought that was pretty funny. I wanted to put the gaming around his neck, like he's using it like a necklace. And he's just like, sign! These Yetis are crazy. I took the snowman from out front, and he's picking her up, and he's going to smash the snowman. And I took one of our Santa reindeer looters that we made in like episode 5. And here I literally wanted it to seem somewhat realistic, where I'm taking the candy off the building and I'm putting it in his wagon. So he took the clock. We're just taking things off and filling up the wagon. So it actually is somewhat realistic. All the missing pieces can be found somewhere. And you know, they're loading up. So I'm just like literally just taking pieces off, like chunks of icing, marshmallows, a couple presents, some lollipops, you know, just pulling things off the building and adding it to this wagon. And this is his loot stash, and he's got his little gingerbread reindeer to take him home. And I thought an idea, like maybe this guy's trying to add a stack of presents to the wagon. I kind of messed up though for a second there, and I didn't duplicate him, so I had to redo it. Then I start bringing in the guys that have the wagons that are hauling things, and I'm just like starting to reuse things now. So I want these looters hauling loot back to the home, so we want to make a path. And those guys, the cyborg Yetis that we made with the skis, I thought they would be cool if we just made them like skiing down that little hill. So, you know, some of them are destroying things, some of them are looting things, and some of them are just having fun. They're all just partaking in the festive fun, doing crazy things. And we really want this gingerbread station to feel like pillaged and destroyed. And when you're coming up in, like if you're a passenger in the train and you're pulling up into the station, I want it to be notably different than the other station. You can see like, whoa, what is wrong with this thing? And there's holes in it. And this here is a blueprint that I found on the Steam Workshop a long time ago. I saw this, it showed up, and I saw a candy pile. And when I saw this, we were working on Yeti Land, and I knew right then and there I had a favorite and subscribe to this, because it was something I was going to do anyways. I was going to build this, but somebody just saved me like, I don't know, an hour or two of work of just placing candy piles. So it's not the most fascinating blueprint, but it's something that we needed, and it's perfect for Yeti Land. So this is sort of like their loot pile. They've all been, we're going to have a little bit of a destroyed town, not just the station. So there'll be a more buildings like the station, and they're taking all that candy that they've been looting, and they're piling it all up here so that these sled guys, the wagon pullers, the carriers, they can all, you know, grab a pile and bring it back home. So it's sort of, again, back to our storytelling, where we want everything to tell a story and we want to create a story. I thought I'd put a piece of the house in there as well, so you can, it tells the story that they're looting this and taking pieces off and piling it up. And the other missing pieces are maybe already back at the cave or been eaten or all sorts of stuff. So I like that candy pile there. It really does help tell the story. I took the wreath and put it around his head because I thought it looked adorable, and taking the stars and stuff. And like I said, they're just having fun. They find something and they go, what is this? They're kind of crazy, primitive little animals, but they're also resourceful, and they try and play with whatever they find. So I thought it would be fun to take a few of these Yetis and stuff them in the candy pile. Like they're busting out of the candy, or they got buried in the candy. They are crazy, and they're all just having fun. So really had fun with this episode, and we're doing all sorts of fun stuff. These guys, I figured we use the snowball fight guys, having a little snowball fight on the train station. Like as I said, when you're coming into this train station as a passenger, you want to really feel like there's some sort of craziness happening here. So you get a nice view of these Yetis, you get a nice view of the destroyed station, and you'll get an idea of what is happening here. So and then I wanted to add a few more looters, because we have guys carrying presents, we got sleigh guys with a stack of toys and presents. We want to have variety. We don't want to just have the same guy carrying the same stack of presents all the way to the, we don't want too much repetition. So repetition's fine if you stagger it properly, and it's efficient in terms of, you know, building art. You don't have to make everything unique, but if you reuse things in between other things, it's hard to notice that it's being reused. So I want to make these guys feel like they're walking down this path. It just poses a lag or two, like they're taking a step. Everything's almost like in pause mode. It's still animated, and we get to take a snapshot of a real-time event going on with these Yetis. So, you know, they're taking cookies back, they're taking presents back, they're taking candy back, and we're gonna fill this path all the way up. So it really does tell a story. And come to think of it now, maybe I should have some Yetis walking in the other direction, coming back for like a second trip. Probably gonna have to do that after, add a few Yetis walking the other way with their arms empty. So I wanted to add some additional looters. Like they have, they're fascinated by all these trinkets and baubles from the Christmas land. So they want to fill up a thing with bells, because we have our little girls that play with the bells. They're kind of like our the Yeti version of the carolers. They play with the instruments and stuff. So the boys are bringing back trinkets for their sisters, and cookies and candy and presents. So they're all preparing to have their own little Christmas celebration where they're all eating candy and opening presents like everybody else gets to. So we're just placing them about and filling up this pathway, and yeah, it's a lot of fun. That one was missing some presents, so I had to rebring him over. I must have missed a few in the selection there. So we're adding the Santa sleigh guy going down this hill, and he's got a stack of presents to bring home. I thought that was kind of fun. And we're just gonna bring, you know, a bunch of them and make a couple changes to them. I think I might even change some of the colors of the presents to make the variation look a little bit different, because that's pretty easy to do. This guy's bringing a stack of hats home. They all like wearing hats. Almost a good half of our Yetis are dressed up with little Christmas decorations. And then I didn't want everybody to be doing the same thing. I wanted to add a little bit of character to, and character and variation to these. So I thought maybe this guy was like tripping on a rock or something, and he's like, he's losing all the presents. He's falling. And I, you know, because this is a still motion snapshot of whatever's happening, all those presents are in mid-flight, his hat's flying off his head, and it makes it look like he tripped and everything's flying out of his hands. I figured adding a little rock there might kind of help tell the story a bit. So he tripped on the rock and he's losing all the gifts. And so every other Yeti that I do here, I'll try and mix it up a little bit, change things a little bit, and decided to dress them up and make them look a little bit different. Add a little bit more females in the group as well. And then we're just trying to stagger it out, but we want enough Yetis so there's a steady stream of looters coming back and forth. By the time we're done this map, we're gonna have hundreds of these Yetis. I mean, we already have quite a bit. So if you see the footage has slowed down, that means we're approaching the end of this episode. We have about 2 minutes here of footage where I just slow the camera down and we get to look at what we created during this episode. So there's still a lot of work to be done on this, and I think that's what the next episode's going to be. I'm not quite sure yet. We're probably going to put more hats on them, make a few more females, put some randomization between them. We're also going to put some more in the cave, going up into the cave, and do some more posing, some more falling. There's the train station that we put in. I love that suggestion. So if you guys do have suggestions for this or something that you want to see go into the map, feel free to put it in the comments below and we'll see if we can try and squeeze that in. The Christmas tree there, we are doing something that I talked about in the previous episodes. Some of you who have been paying attention to the whole series will know what we're doing with that tree. So that'll be coming up in one of the later episodes too. So we still have a ton of footage left. I'm going to try and probably get out a new episode for you guys almost every day or every other day until the weekend. and then we'll probably have more footage for next week once the weekend is over, once I get to work on it a little bit more. So we're just getting a good look at everything that we've done so far, and yeah, it's been a lot of fun. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode, and if you did, please be sure to smash that like button. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. If you have suggestions, leave them down in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. This has been a fun process, and I think we're going to have a lot more good episodes this week, and we're going to be able to actually start our Let's Play, hopefully after this weekend, maybe. Or we're going to start building some coasters and stuff. Anyways, lots of fun stuff to come. Thank you guys again so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next episode of Yeti Land.